The show that has been adopted by Netflix after almost not being continued for its next outing, Lucifer, showed big devoted fanbase surrounding it, and they would walk through hell for the show. However, today we're going to take a look at some of the things that the show and the main character have or said at some point during the series, and also how some of these things are just not gotten right by the fans. Enjoy! Number 10. God's Participation. Now yes, in the last final scenes of the show, we got to see God in his material form. But if we take a look back, his participation has not been that great. Despite all the points and mentions to him, fans must have forgotten that his participation has not been that impactful, especially when it comes to his responsibilities.
It's real good seeing you, Samael.
What did you say?
You might not have noticed this right away, or still haven't, but after Amenadiel was sent to take Lucifer back to hell, he seems to have a say in many things, but also hides behind many of his, as we said before, responsibilities. Eve was also introduced in the show, and it's perplexing to consider how she got away. How can God's first creation leave heaven? And plus, it looks like he doesn't even care. And this is a big deal. Number 9. Lucifer's time on Earth. Even from the start of the series, Lucifer is presented living his life on Earth, in a human body, but the show never really troubled itself to mention how long he's been on Earth. Fans are aware that Lucifer used to pop from time to time for some fun if not more, and also with Lux being a major hit, you can't just appear out of nowhere and have the audience Lucifer has and his club. But the thing that fans don't know is how long he's been on Earth, months, weeks, years, or perhaps more. Some said that it has been long, and some might say years, when all the things are considered, but that's where they're wrong, because it was never mentioned just how long his stay on Earth has been before joining the gang. Number 8. A civilian consultant. No one, even we're bamboozled, and have a lot of questions about how Lucifer is able to help the murder cases. He becomes involved with Chloe Decker after his friend is murdered, he's taken in as a civilian consultant, and what's even crazier is that the police captain approved this.
I don't see it.
I'm now an official civilian consultant for the LAPD.
Fans might think that he's doing a great job, but it just doesn't make sense since he has not done any police training. He has no forensic skills or any detective knowledge. He simply works by what he knows as the devil, but the thing that fans got wrong from his, let's call it a job, is that it's there only for his involvement with Chloe throughout the series. Because let's face it, if it wasn't for their duo of solving crimes, not much would be connecting them. Number 7. Baby Charlie. One of the biggest mysteries in Season 4, for which we didn't get a clearing, is Baby Charlie. He was conceived by accident due to Amenadiel not knowing that an angel can impregnate a human. However, the implications of the half-angel child are not explored any further. With this in mind, according to common tales, a child born to an angel and a human is called Nephilim. And yes, the show pointed out that he can enter and leave heaven without damage, but in lore, Nephilim aren't really well-liked by the rules of heaven. And thus, fans got the whole situation wrong, because it's sad to say that they used this character to just progress the storyline that he's technically in line of ruling hell. Number 6. The flow of cash. Next on the list, we have a detail that many fans got wrong, or just didn't get at all, and that is that Lucifer for sure has plenty of cash, but where does it come from? Sure, Lux is always crowded and brings in a lot of money, but everything has an end. And with mentioning Lux, the question comes, where did he get the capital to open a luxury business in the first place? Did he have a social security number? One thing mentioned in the series was that his lease was written in lipstick on a pair of underwear. And for us, this is just not enough. We don't get it too. You're not alone. Number 5. How souls get to hell. When the question of how souls get banished to hell, the answer has had shifts throughout the show. And in the grand scheme of things, it's a detail many fans got wrong, or just simply chose to ignore. Everyone knows that a person has to commit a sin to enter hell, but Lucifer explains that those who know are guilty are damned, and an additional explanation is given that those who truly believe that they hold no guilt can leave hell, which doesn't make any sense in the show, because Lucifer's mother, the goddess, was able to escape, so even if deranged murderers honestly believe that they have done wrong, they can leave hell too? Number 4. Anatomy. Maze is Lucifer's trusty sidekick, and most of the time, she does the dirtiest work for him. Her physical form is near perfect, but it's also a theme that leaves a lot of questions unanswered. Demons have no soul, and Maze said that if she's ever killed on Earth, she'll go straight back to hell. and can't possess another body. So according to things, fans were given false information about how demons look like, and that is the thing they have mistaken about it. Because according to the Bible, demons don't look anything like the humans. At one point, they've even been described as beasts with 10 heads. Number 3. What's in a name? Lucifer Morningstar, a name given to the devil in the series, the ruler of hell, the fallen angel, who was banished by his father to rule hell as part of his punishment for not playing by the rules, the description the show gave us. However, this name suggests a sloppy translation because Lucifer is the Latin name of the planet we call Venus. The word literally means lightbringer, and due to the movements of Venus across the night sky, it's often associated with mythologies that includes falls from heaven. So the partly invalid details associated with the main character's name got the fans thinking that this is the right thing, but in reality, they're far from it. Number 2. Police work. Now yes, the show has some otherworldly elements in it, supernatural even, but not every police work is as easy as the corner cuts taken when the devil was on the scene of the crime. And this is exactly what the show portrayed to the fans, and the viewers at home giving wrong path to getting the job done. Good police work begins with keen skill for observation and a closer look into the problem at hand. At one point, Amenadiel stops time and allows Lucifer to move from one location to another instantly, an event that should have raised a lot of questions from the police officers surrounding him. However, it was rather forgotten about it, like nothing happened. Number 1. Who tortures who? The show follows the traditional interpretation of hell, a place where lost souls are tortured for eternity, and Lucifer's personality is really wrapped up in his career, even though he's retired. On numerous occasions, it's unclear as to who exactly is responsible for the torture of these souls. Lucifer referenced a couple of times torturing victims in hell, but contradicts himself as management and claiming not to be hands-on. Maze's skills of physical torture and interrogation are well established in the show too. Still, these different types of tortures put together with the scenes given that lost souls torture themselves with their deepest guilt gave the fans the wrong direction, and many of them got the things wrong and mixed up as to what is the real truth in the scheme of things as to who tortures who, and on what premise. On a related note, tell us down in the comments below what part of the series has been the biggest mystery for you, and why. And also don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon if you'd like to see more videos like this in the future. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time.